This edition of iItaly New York is brought to you by...
L'energia non si ferma. Mai. L'energia crea. Si trasforma. Diventa un'idea per generare nuova energia. Diamo all'energia un'energia nuova.
And DeCecco Pasta. Imported in the U.S. since 1893.
In this week's episode, we will promote Italian language in American schools. Our Pasta Mania series continues with Orecchiette con Broccoli. Professor Tamburri reviews poets of the Italian diaspora. Let's celebrate our summer party, iItaly Under the Stars. Let's start with the promotion of bilingualism.
This event was put together with the aim of presenting a dual language program in Italian to parents entering K in 2015-2016. We already have one very successful, and we would like to replicate this experience in public schools in the city.
The French community started the French bilingual revolution 7 years ago. We started with 24 children in Carroll Garden in Brooklyn. Today, we have about 1,300 students in 10 schools, and hopefully there'll be 20 more in the next few years.
We came up with the idea of this meeting that we are having today because we didn't know how many people, how many Italians, how many Italian Americans could be involved, how to get them involved. And after just a few days, we received hundreds of information. And I hope this is only the first step, and in a few years we are gonna open several projects.
La cultura e la lingua italiana è parte di un retaggio molto ricco che è molto importante di preservarlo in vari modi, in particolare fra i giovani. Questo dual language program è un ottimo veicolo per questo obiettivo di realizzarsi.
The New York City Department of Education is very committed to bilingual education. We currently have over 400 bilingual programs in our schools. They are offered in 9 different languages. And we know that as a population, students who speak Italian at home represents over 800 students. So we look forward to having the opportunity to do that in partnership with our families and communities who support our Italian speakers.
Una famiglia che si è formata qua a New York, siamo italiani genitori e mio figlio è nato qui. Parlerà molto presto un inglese migliore del mio, ma non so se parlerà un italiano buono quanto il mio, e questo per me è un aspetto molto importante, perché condividere la lingua italiana con compagni di classe italiani e americani, dove c'è un interscambio culturale, è di fondamentale importanza perché questo scambio possa portare all'approfondimento della nostra cultura.
L'altro aspetto che io reputo molto interessante è che noi veniamo dall'Europa, che è un continente dove normalmente due lingue, tre lingue sono abbastanza comuni, si studiano fin dalla tenera età. Questo paese è un po' diverso, quindi secondo me l'opportunità di avere una bambina capace di parlare due lingue è un valore aggiunto in questo paese, dove io comunque credo di stare per qualche anno.
Siamo qui perché la lingua è sicuramente porta la cultura, porta tutte le nostre tradizioni, tutto quello che noi, anche così lontani dalla nostra terra, ci portiamo dentro. E la lingua è il modo in cui noi riusciremo a passare ai nostri figli questo. La lingua è ovviamente la vicinanza ad altre famiglie.
We
We need to make sure that we are continuing to develop and maintain the home language. Their parents are their first teachers. And so to value and respect that, we want to bring that into the schools and use that as learning opportunities for our students.
A bilingual kid is much more open to another culture because it's exposed, obviously, to another language, another way of seeing the world and experiencing the world.
Maintain the culture, the language, which was one of the main needs of the Italian American community. I realize it's a universal and essential needs of all the people who live abroad.
Families have access to bilingual education. They can protect their heritage, which is also great for us, for the promotion of our country. It's a win-win situation.
This is Pasta Mania. Follow us on iItaly TV.
This is pasta. Real Italian pasta. Pasta is serious business. Pasta is love. And pasta making is love making. Did you know that the best pasta makers clean the grains one by one? They just keep the heart. The best pasta is bronze drawn and slow dried at low temperatures. Remember, to make an excellent pasta dish, use excellent pasta. Today's recipe is orecchiette broccoli. Orecchiette is a classic type of pasta from Apulia, whose name literally means little ears, in reference to its shape. There are countless variations on this dish in different parts of the region. Sometimes broccoli rabe is prepared with lard or sausage, other times with anchovies. Other times it's served plain with pecorino cheese. This one includes anchovies and pecorino, or ricotta salata, a real treat. Ingredients. First, you'll need 12 ounces of orecchiette, 40 ounces of broccoli, cleaned, 4 tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil, 2 cloves of garlic, 2 anchovy fillets, 4 ounces of pecorino or ricotta salata, chili pepper as desired. Now that we're ready, let's see how Chef Luca Stefani does it. Preparation. Let's start with the pasta first this time. Pour water in a large pot and bring to a boil. Then add coarse salt and toss in the orecchiette. Pour large chunks of broccoli in and cook with the pasta. The broccoli will flavor the water and the orecchiette. Meanwhile, brown 2 cloves of garlic over a low flame with extra virgin olive oil and 2 anchovy fillets. Coarsely chop anchovies and mix thoroughly. Remove garlic as soon as it turns golden, making sure it doesn't burn. After 11 minutes, your broccoli and pasta will be ready. Don't strain it, just remove it from the pot using a large slotted spoon and add it to the saucepan. Cook in the pan with sauce for a few minutes, stirring thoroughly. Sprinkle with pecorino or ricotta salata and continue stirring until it has melted. Before serving, add chili pepper to taste. A number of southern Italian wines would pair perfectly with this robustly flavorful dish. Traditionally, you should use a red wine such as Ciro, a very tannic and full-bodied fruity wine from Calabria. Remember, to make an excellent pasta dish, use excellent pasta.
Check out Italian Genius.
Today I'm glad to talk to you about this book I'm going to show you, Poets of the Italian Diaspora. It is a 1,500-page anthology that deals with Italian writing outside of Italy. What I mean by Italian writing is that there are people outside of Italy, they live their daily lives outside of Italy, and they write in Italian, both in prose and in poetry, in verse. This book is dedicated to the writing in verse form from 12 different countries around the world. And it is accompanied by an English translation, that is every poem, every original verse written in Italian is then translated. It is put together by Luigi Bonafini and Joseph Perricone, two scholars and most able translators of Italian, and they have also enlisted the help of many other translators to produce this final product. It is an historical book because it deals, in fact, with the very recognition of this type of writing outside of Italy, which we know that the sort of conservative element of the Italian literary critical establishment has not recognized this throughout, let's say, the last 130 years at least, with regard to the United States and with regard to the mass emigration from Italy at the end of the 19th century. So I say to you, in the spirit of this book, buona lettura and happy reading.
This is what's coming up.
I Italy rocks.
I Italy rocks.
I Italy rocks.
I Italy rocks.
I Italy you rock.
I Italy rocks.
I Italy rocks.
I Italy rocks.
I Italy rocks twice.
We're getting ready for a great I Italy party.
This place is wonderful. Tonight is gonna be amazing. There are gonna be a lot of people that are gonna help us to make this party a great Italian experience.
È veramente bello essere in compagnia questa sera per questa festa d'estate che è un po' bagnata, ma dicono festa bagnata, festa fortunata, qui sarà un successo strepitoso. A Italy è una grande amica, come la pasta di Giovanni Rana, perché ti fa sentire a casa, ti fa sentire in Italia, in qualunque posto tu sia. Leggendo, consultando il sito, piuttosto che guardandola in televisione, tu senti l'autenticità, la verità del nostro paese, ma al tempo stesso la modernità di essere radicati negli Stati Uniti.
Quando parlo qua mi sembra di essere in Italia, naturalmente sono italiano, e quando iniziate a parlare del nostro bella Italia sono sempre disponibile. Quando parlo della mia Italia parlo del mangiare, e il mangiare è qualcosa che gli italiani è la prima cosa che parlano.
Noi siamo un ristorante, ci troviamo a Chelsea Market e dalla colazione alla tarda notte serviamo il menù di Giovanni Rana in ogni modo, per ogni esigenza, perché la pasta può essere un'amica ad ogni orario. Ma non solo questo, ci occupiamo anche di catering, perché la pasta, tutte le ricette prelibate che facciamo possono raggiungere ogni luogo, non solo il nostro ristorante. E quindi accompagniamo i nostri clienti, i nostri ospiti in tutte quelle feste, in tutti quei momenti preziosi della loro vita in cui hanno voglia di avere intorno qualcosa di vero, di autentico italiano, come stasera.
Sono molto curiosa da questa cosa. Quanto è presente il vino anche nelle sue ricette? Cucina con il vino per caso o c'è del vino nel suo formaggio?
Nei tortellini viene sempre accompagnato dei vini. Qua c'è un prosecco meraviglioso io lo accompagno sempre con il parmigiano reggiano, però si può accompagnare con qualsiasi formaggio. Naturalmente il prosecco è un vino veneto, trevigiano, dove veramente si accompagna veramente con questi, tutte le forme di vini, particolarmente col parmigiano.
Siamo qui ospiti in questo grandissimo e meraviglioso evento per celebrare appunto questa, come dire, questa missione di Aitaly a New York.
Tell us about being on the cover of I Italy this month.
It was a shocking surprise. When Ottorino came back, he said, I brought you something you won't believe. And there I was. Well, I did a lecture for them. Well, a lecture, not the right word. A presentation on Italian futurism. I sponsored this, well, one of the sponsors of this exhibit at the Guggenheim.
What do you love about I Italy?
Well, that it's here. That's significant to me. We always had a certain lack of communication about Italian things to American audiences, except through the prism of either Italian-American culture or through the Italian language publications like Oggi. This is quite different, and it fills a very good place in the scope of things.
I love iItaly. I really think that it's great to show modern Italy, things that are happening in America, things that are interesting to Italian Americans.
Yeah, well, you know what's really different is that many of the things in the past were sort of passive. It's almost as if Italy for many years was here through the rearview mirror. We were looking at what had happened. This has vitality, a great deal of presence, moment, and energy. And no, there's no other word for it. It's got energy, and it makes us all feel the same way.
Quando sono arrivata esisteva soltanto il sito web, dopodiché è diventato un magazine, una trasmissione televisiva, sta andando benissimo, credo che sia un punto di riferimento importante per l'Italia a New York, ma anche nel mondo, perché non credo che esistano altre realtà in lingua inglese che parlino d'Italia in lingua inglese, e questo è estremamente importante, perché se vogliamo far parlare delle tante cose belle del paese dobbiamo farlo anche in una lingua che è la lingua più utilizzata.
Is such a great resource for New Yorkers, for Italians in New York to find out what's going on in New York, which I love because I love going out, I love seeing what's going on in Italian culture, Italian food, Italian performances going on in the city, so no one does it better than iItaly, that's for sure.
And what about this party tonight, what do you think?
It's incredible. I mean, the space is gorgeous. To be in a penthouse in the middle of Wall Street, it's like, you know, who could do that? I mean, to pull it together in the summertime, it's wonderful. I love it. And it's New York style with an Italian flair.
Well, for us with the love of Italy, and you don't have to be Italian to fit into that category, it's a wonderful resource of everything that's going on here in America, in New York. And I look at it all the time, and I really enjoy it. It's got better every day.
Italy is a way of bringing Italy into the United States that's never been done before. It's a very exciting way. It's a very professional way. The design, the contents, and I'm just so proud to be a part of it.
And what do you think of this party?
This party is great. The food is nice. It would be best if we were outside. I think we should have one of these every few months, just so everybody can see each other.
iItaly has been able to create the Italian community in New York. When you're in an iItaly medium, whether it's the website or the television program, you feel like you're in Italy. They put you in touch with all the cultural aspects of the country and whatever is going on in New York. It's a wonderful addition. I particularly love the website. It's just so full of information that you can't get anywhere else.
We are happy to have tonight some limoncello mixed with the tonic and mint. So we're trying to enjoy limoncello as opposed to just some dessert or digestive.
And tell us the name of the company.
The company name is Arvero, which means tree in Napolitan.
And so what I love about it is the wonderful cocktails that they're inventing in Italy with it.
Well, iItaly is very truthful to the Italian heritage and to everything that Italians do in New York and love in New York. So it's the most strong testament that we have here. So it's fantastic.
So we'll discover great limoncello drinks, and we're having them here at the fabulous celebration of I, Italy.
I love Italy because more or less have the same name like us, Italy and I, Italy. And I love I, Italy because represent the best description of what's happening in the city, in the Italian soul.
Ho scoperto grandissime cose meravigliose, perché New York è piena di cose italiane fantastiche, della nostra cultura, della nostra storia, e anche di quello che sarà il futuro del nostro paese, se riusciremo a far sì che l'Italia torni ad essere amata.
Hi, we're here with Anthony, who's written so much about restaurants around the country. Anthony, what do you love about I, Italy?
I like reading about people like us, about Italian things around the city, and news of Italy. I have to confess that I write for the site every now and then. It's a great site. It's got art, it's got music, it's got culture, it's got politics.
Yeah, I'm gonna like do this kind of performance. I already did once, and there is a canvas under a denim fabric. I will scratch out the first layer of fabric, and you will see slowly by slowly the artwork that is behind.
And so we're gonna get to see that live. But meantime, I'd like to know more about these paintings that are all around the room at this wonderful celebration for I, Italy. Tell us about this painting that we're looking at right here.
Yeah, it's called this body of work is called Homage, and our works are realized over the poster of Palazzo Reale. So I used to detach the poster from the street and put on wood and make my own reinterpretation, leaving the details of the original artwork.
And as an Italian community, we're also very proud of Italy. And to be here enjoying this wonderful night, I run a law firm and we represent a lot of Italian companies that bring over personnel or just Italian individuals that are coming here to work, to act, to practice their art. And we do visas, green cards, and we try to get them here in a way that enables them to realize their American dream. And, you know, we do our part.
Ci sono sempre stati nei momenti più importanti della comunità, in particolare a quelli a cui io tengo di più, ho ottenuto di più, come la Scuola d'Italia, il Gala della Scuola d'Italia, la Camera di Commercio.
Con iItaly collaboriamo già da un po', ci piace iItaly perché si rivolge al pubblico italiano e non per rappresentare le eccellenze dell'Italia. All'Italia vuole essere vicina alle comunità, all'Italian Heritage così presente negli Stati Uniti.
Enzo, sì? Allora, che stai bevendo?
Prosecco, ovviamente. Io non posso bere tanto dell'altro cocktail, se no stasera non arrivo a casa, ma il prosecco va sempre bene.
Guarda, da iItaly sì. Tu trovi il meglio del meglio.
Questo lo so, io collaboro pure con la rivista iItaly, scrivo di jazz, c'è una columna ogni mese.
Raccontiamo il nostro segreto di stasera.
Sì. Abbiamo deciso, incontrandoci stasera qui sotto all'ingresso, per la prima volta nella nostra vita noi due, di botto, improvviso, di dividere eventualmente il premio della raffle, come si chiama, la lotteria, che è un viaggio aereo, quindi chi dei due dovesse vincere lo viaggia insieme all'altro. Mi sembra una bella cosa, no?
La bendata, ci vedi? Bravissima la bendata, papà. Ah! 1-6-4-0-2-0 1-6-4-0-2-0
C'è un legame ormai forte da anni a livello personale con tutto lo staff di Aitaly, anche con il nostro locale, abbiamo collaborato e continueremo a collaborare. E stiamo crescendo insieme, speriamo noi di raggiungere il loro livello, ormai loro sono planetari.
Hi Italy rocks!
Hi Italy rock!
Hi Italy rocks!
This edition of iItaly TV was brought to you by Colavita Extra Virgin Olive Oil and Baci Perugina Chocolate. Say I love you in the Italian way.
In the next week episode, Stefano Albertini interviews Oscar-nominated director Gianni Amelio. The president of Italy's House of Representatives visits Ellis Island. Pasta Mania continues with spaghetti con pomodoro e basilico. Professor Fred Gardafè reviews Siciliana.